Hello everyone, today I'm going to introduce you some word games. In my presentation, I prepared different examples for each game to diversify the examples in our book and to show that each of these games can be easily adapted into different topics. Let's get started. Today we will talk about these seven games. Our first game is Vocabulary Squares. In vocabulary squares, words can be written horizontally, vertically, or diagonally. For older children, you can write the words from right to left or from bottom to top. If you make a copy before you put the other letters, you can easily find where they are. In vocabulary squares, all the words should be written in the same theme. You can arrange the difficulty as well. For younger children, the words that they look for, and for older children, pictures, the topic, or the written definition of each item can be given. Our next game is Hangman. As you know, this game can be played in teams. One child or teacher, let's say a thinker, thinks of a word and writes dashes on the board to represent each letter. The rest of the children try to guess the letters. If they cannot guess the letters correctly, the thinker draws one line of the picture. If they cannot guess the word before the picture is finished, the thinker thinks of a new word. But, is it good for children's psychology? In my opinion, it may affect their psychology negatively. That's why I prepared a variation for this game. We can turn it into an activity similar to computer games by preparing a heart-shaped symbol like this. We can give 5 symbols for each group, and once they did not know the letter, we can take one of them. And when they know the word, we can give all 5 symbols to the winner group. The group who loses all the symbols first will automatically lose the game as well. The other game is Word Chain. This game can be played in teams. The teacher writes a starter word on the board, and one student from each team comes to the board to add a new word that starts with the last letter of the previous word. To make it harder, the starter word can be written in the middle. So children can create words either starts with the last letter of the previous word or ends with the first letter of the word. As far as I remembered from my previous experiences, you can also put some limitations to make it harder and funnier for older children, like you cannot use pronouns or colors. The fourth game is Words from Words. In this game, the teacher writes a long word or a short sentence on the board, and the students try to make new words by using only the letters in the given word. To diversify the examples of our book, I played this game with the word grandfather for you. Let's see how many words I can create. Thank you. The next game is tennis. This game is played by pairs, but this time the ball is words. In this game, one child serves a word and the other child should return a word from the same word family. The game continues until one of them cannot think of a word. As a variation, instead of word families, you can use words beginning with the same letter or a word beginning with the last letter of the previous word, as we did in the word chain. The sixth game is set of words. For this game, a worksheet is prepared with words from 5 or 6 different word families, and all the words are mixed up. Then, the students are asked to put them into correct categories. To make it easier for younger children, you can give the name of the category as well. The last game is information gap crosswords. This game can be beneficial to revise the newly learned vocabulary. In this game, students work in pairs. First of all, the teacher prepares the crossword with the answers, then prepares 2 different versions. In one of them, the half of the words is put, and in the other version, the other half is given. Students are asked to define the words on their version to their partners by using language, mime, or pictures. The game continues until both children have completed their version.
Thank you for watching my presentation.